Want to add cinematic fog to your photos? Today I'll show you 3 awesome ways to create fog in Lightroom Mobile. Fast, easy, and stunning. Starting with the background fog. Here we have a photo with not a hint of fog whatsoever. Masking filters are where the fog is mainly created, especially for this image. So here in the masking filters, there is this new select background option which selects everything other than the subject. After a few seconds of AI processing on the cloud, the selection is done. But for this edit, I want to exclude the selection on the foreground. So I'm gonna tap subtract from mask 1 and select linear gradient filter and place it on the foreground. Tapping on the filter reveals the mask. You can see the 2 subfilters here, the background filter and the subtract linear gradient filter. Fine-tuning the mask here. Now to apply some effects on this mask, first I'm gonna try removing contrast from these areas. Not touching the contrast slider here. Starting by increasing shadows, which brightens the darker parts of the area. Similarly, increasing blacks, which brightens the darkest parts. Similarly, reducing whites, which further reduces contrast. Also, reducing exposure to darken the background a bit. Next, going to the effects menu, adding haze by moving the dehaze slider to the left. Moving the slider to around -84. Also, reducing clarity a bit. This further reduces the details in the background. There is also this part where the distance is further, so need to be more foggy on those parts. So adding a linear gradient filter and fine-tuning the selection by making the edges more sharp. Adding more haze and little bit of exposure. Before and after to see the big difference here. After applying these filters, I'm going to detail menu and move the masking slider with 2 fingers to fine-tune the selection. So the sharpening effect is applied only on the white parts of the image. Then moving the sharpening amount slider towards right to add sharpening, which gives pop to the subject here. Now to atmospheric fog. Have this clear image of woods. We'll do some global tuning here. Starting in the light menu, I'll first increase the blacks to lift the darkest parts to lighter shades. Reducing whites to dampen the brightest parts. Similarly, increasing shadows and reducing highlights. Reducing the exposure too. Going to the effects menu, reducing overall clarity a bit. I'm not touching the dehaze slider here. In the color menu, reducing the overall vibrance to remove some color from the image. You can see all the contrast and color being subdued from the original. Now moving to the masking filters, I'm mainly going to add the fog on the areas closer to the ground as that is where most of the fog is present. Adding a linear gradient filter and placing it somewhere around here. Also, I'm going to add a subtract linear gradient mask to remove the selection around the bottom parts of the image. Now you can see the selection made where the effects will be applied for this filter. First, adding haze by moving the dehaze slider towards left. Next, I will add a similar filter, a bit narrower selection than the first one with linear gradient filters. Here again, moving the dehaze slider towards left, which adds more fog. Adding whites to make those areas brighter. To make these areas more bright, I will just duplicate this filter by long tapping and selecting duplicate. Duplicating it few times to get the look of the fog I want. We'll also add a luminance range filter and move the filter to around here to select only the parts similar to the brightness range of that area, making the selection a bit more soft. Subtracting the mask with a linear gradient filter at the top. With a bit more haze, here's the before and after. Now to add some cinematic fog with a hue. This urban night image looks really good, but we are gonna try to change the complexion of this image by adding some fog. In masking filters, I'm gonna first select background. There is some foreground added to the mask which I want to remove. So subtracting the mask with a linear gradient filter, making sure the selection is close to what I want. For this masking filter, in the effects menu, adding haze and reducing clarity too. reducing a bit of exposure, also contrast a lot here, increasing shadows and blacks. Next in the color menu, reducing the temperature for some cooler tint. To get the cyan tint for the fog, I'll move to the color option and move the pointer to around here. Just eyeballing the color here, which gets this output. But we're gonna go a bit further to make it further pop. First, I'm gonna tune the exposure further. Also tuning the overall contrast with curves in the light menu. Going back to masking filters, I'm gonna try to make the background more interesting by adding a radial filter around the head of the subject, making sure to soften the feather here. Also, making sure to remove the subject from the selection by subtracting it from the main radial filter. Now, I will increase the exposure and whites to pop that part. Also moving the dehaze slider to minus 100, reducing the clarity and texture too. More brightening, removing more details by reducing the contrast. This seems to have overshadowed the subject a bit. So, making a separate subject filter and increasing the whites to pop the subject. Coming out of the masking filters, in the effects menu, adding a vignette to the overall image to get this final look. Hope you found the video useful and subscribe for more. See you soon in my next video. Thanks for watching.